Maverick Vinales created quite a lot of headlines by deciding to split from Yamaha at the end of this year, despite having a contract for next year as well. Initially, there were a lot of rumours that he would sign with Aprillia next year. However, those rumours have since died down. Vinales has now revealed his current plans for the future while speaking to the media during a track day at Barcelona, as quoted by Motorsport. I'm your host, Dillon Shelley, and first up on Moto World, Vinales to take a sabbatical next year? Vinales began by confirming that his future plans haven't progressed. It is at a standstill. Now I want to enjoy my holidays, because the first half of the season has been quite hard and I want to enjoy with my family. He also revealed that he has no current agreements with any team. I have nothing with anyone. I want to take it easy and we'll see what happens in 2022. Well, it's clear that it wouldn't be the best thing to do, because you have to compete. He also reiterated that he needs a project he enjoys or he will just stay at home. The most important thing is to compete, but if I'm not at ease and I don't enjoy myself, what frustrates me the most is that I can't give my 100%, and if I can't give it, I prefer to stay at home and enjoy life. He also pointed out his current situation and he plans to change that after the summer break. In the end, everything goes by very quickly, and in this world we live in, 10 years fly by and you don't enjoy them. Right now, as we were working, I didn't enjoy anything on the circuits. In this second part of the season, I want to change that dynamic, enjoy and give the maximum. He also affirmed that he will continue to behave professionally with Yamaha, despite knowing that their relationship will come to an end soon. For me, nothing changes. I will give everything I have, and if they make me try things, I will try them, and I will give them the right information. I will be a professional, as I should be. Fast feed. Honda's Paul Espargaro has suggested that confidentiality and the Japanese go hand in hand. He added that the Honda riders expect a lot of new things, not just the chassis. The bike needs quite a few changes to make it work and to adapt to the rear tyre. Petronas Yamaha's team principal Raslan Razali thinks that with six riders across the three categories, it's difficult to make one general summary on how the team has performed. He also confirmed that they are still waiting to hear Valentino Rossi and Yamaha's decision about next year. He further revealed that they have been receiving interest from a lot of riders and even riders that are currently outside the MotoGP Championship. So, with all this interest, they will take their time to evaluate every rider who they would like. There won't be any potential lineup announcements until after the next couple of races, confirmed Rosali. VR46's Luca Marini feels that his coach and former 125cc world champion, Roberto Locatelli, was a fantastic rider. He's a fan of Locatelli and it's great now to have the opportunity to work with him. Ducati's Jack Miller thinks that the team has got some validation, but the real validation will be by the end of the year, as far as the rider lineup is concerned. We did a good job, and Pecco and I, especially Pecco, has been very consistent. I'm trying my best to do my best job, Miller added. I think we're doing a good job for the team and for the manufacturer. The manufacturer championship, we are right there, and also in the riders, Miller suggested. Retired MotoGP world champion Marco Lucanelli has explained that when he says that Valentino should have given up, he doesn't say it with the air of superiority of someone who wants to teach. In his opinion, it's ugly to see him so far behind, because it's not a question of a motorcycle. The others with the same bike are ahead, he added. Tech 3 KTM's team manager Hervé Poncharal knew that by losing Miguel Oliveira to the factory team, they would lose a lot. But, in the end, they lost even more than they could have imagined. It's not easy at the moment, although Ica and Danilo are lovely guys. Should Maverick Vinales take a sabbatical next year? Head over to my community page to vote in the poll and let me know what you think in the comments. And if you like this video, feel free to subscribe and check out my others for all the latest in the world of MotoGP.